presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Oh, look who we have.
It's a beautiful thing. Look at our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We got it taken by storm.
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But
yeah.
Holy, I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about, whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Make it a great week, folks. Don't take anything personally. Your truth is personal to you. Your own opinions and point of view reflect your own agreements and are personal to you. It's no one's truth but yours. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 26, NASDAQ up 13, S&P's up 3, gold contract up $3.50, trading at $14.72 an ounce. You get silver up 5 cents, $17 flat. Late sweet crude off 86 cents, $56.86 a barrel. Notes and bonds, you get the 10-year up 5 ticks, 129.10. 30-year up 13 at 158.23. King dollar down 213 ticks. Trading 97.787. The euro is at 110. The yen is at 108.65. And the pound is at 129 to one U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world and the world of the S&Ps? What do you have? You're another day, you're another dollar, and you're another high. We take a look at the S&P, the SPY out here. All-time high. We hit an all-time high on Friday. You closed out Friday in the SPY at 311. You're at 312.09. Yep, you got a contraction of volume, but the bottom line, you continue at higher price. NDX 100, same type of setup inside the NDX 100. And the three Qs right now, trading up 30 cents. You're at 203.21. Dow Industrials, also the same inside the Dow Industrials. Dow Industrials right now, trading up 24 bucks at 28,030. Small caps, different ballgame. It's just showing how basically weak the small cap index actually is. You get the IWM is actually down 38 cents, just can't handle price. So you still have monster divergence there. The small caps, they topped out in July of 2018. Yes, that's what you heard, folks, July of 2018. So pretty wild. Gold contract out here, rejected lower price out here this morning, caught a bid. Bottom line is that gold wants higher price, and we'll see how this baby's shaking out. But quite a day out here today. We were at 1456 this morning. You're at 1471. You got 321,000 contracts, and anything inside this 1470 gets you in the higher range once again. Silver, same type of setup inside the silver market. Silver also caught the bid out here. Silver right now is trading at a price point up 6 cents. You rejected $16.70 and anything inside $16.94. Yeah, $16.98. You're a couple pennies inside it. Get you in the higher range. So we'll see if silver itself can bust out of this range. Gold bottom line is out of the range. Notes and bonds. The note and bond market, folks, this is just amazing, actually. Continue to want higher price. And it's pretty intense how this thing is basically shaken out. You have the 10-year note up 5 ticks today. Now, last Thursday, it had some big strength. It got back inside the higher range. We're at 129.09 right now in the 10. That's looking to go up to that 132 mark. We look at the 30-year. 30-year is set up the same way, meaning that we got I've got an additional 12 ticks out here. We're at 158.22. That 30-year is looking to get up into this 165 area. Last Thursday, also, this jumped right back in the higher range. Anything above 157.17 gets you inside that higher range. And that's exactly what they did. The 10-year yield right now, we are at 1.81. That's where we're at. Bottom line, looks like it wants to run down to approximately the 1.6 area. King dollar. What do we have with king dollar out here? King dollar right now. Come on, baby. Let's see. Where are we at? There we go. Maybe. King dollar's 97.795. So we've had 3 days down in king dollar. King dollar looks like it's going to get down to the lower end of this range it's been in, 97.141. And what that's about today, folks, is that the pound has actually caught a bid today over in the UK. Pound's up 60 ticks, trading 129.57. The euro hasn't really caught the bid yet. If the euro catches the bid, then you can see that dollar come down with some conviction. The euro is up 23 ticks out here, 110. Not bad. Bottom line, though, because the dollar index is 60% of the euro, it's when the euro basically gets cracked that you'll see that dollar go much higher. Oil, let's go over to the oil market out here. This oil market continues to have a tough time. And let's go. We get the December contract right now. We are trading down 89 cents. We're at $56.83. That failed to hold price out here today and dramatically lighter volume. So I expect what we're going to see inside that oil market, it's going to try to basically first get down into this 55 area. If you get there with conviction like we traded down today from the 58 to 56, then you're going to be down the very bottom of this consolidation, which is the $50 mark. What's so intriguing about the oil market right now is that you have Saudi Arabia come out over the weekend, folks. Saudi Aramco was going to be the biggest IPO in the marketplace to ever take place. Bottom line, that's not going to be the case right now. They're going to be basically, it's going to be in a Saudi Arabia affair, basically, meaning that first off, they shook down the largest wealthier citizens out there to buy shares in the IPO. Then the actual individual investors, they changed the rules at the central bank that you're going to be able to do double leverage to buy it. Bottom line is they're going to push out 1.6 trillion to 1.7 trillion. What that's telling me is that we get so much oil out here because they are doing huge amounts of pressure to get this IPO out on the market. I suspect once they get it out on the market, of course, then they can, it's only 1.5% of the company, but then they can use that as paper. Bottom line is they're going to get it pushed out. So I expect you're going to see more downward pressure on the oil market because what we have had, there's no two ways about this, is that we've had the aspect that, bottom line, oil has had a really tough time at the $60 mark at all above. And the companies themselves are having a hard time staying in business at oil being 55 or 60. So I suspect we're going to see some more destruction inside of that whole sector. Dow Industrials right now up 25. You get the NASDAQ up 14. S&Ps are up 3.5. Those are all at all-time highs, folks. Stay right there, folks. I'm Mr. Steve Rhodes coming up next. We're going to be talking the markets. Coming right back.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionics, oil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. We have the Dow Industrials down 9, NASDAQ are 4, S&P's flat. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Steve Rhodes, as we do each and every Monday. Excuse me, folks, at 20 past the hour. And don't forget, folks, Steve has an outstanding show here every trading day. 1 to 2 Eastern Standard Time. Also, is a great newsletter, the Mastering Probability. Now, as you come over and you're looking at these slides, you're going to see our man, Mr. Steve Rhodes, also is the 2018 Timer of the Year, and we're coming into 2020. So it is going to be the next one is going to be the 2019 Timer of the Year. Bottom line, folks, is that real easy to get his newsletter. You come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to go right under featured content. You got Master Probability right there. You can sign up for 1 month, for 6 months, or a year. All come with a 30-day money-back guarantee. 1 month, it's $149. 6 months, folks, is $695, which is a savings of $199. A year is $1,195, which is a savings of $593. Bottom line, check it out. You can sign up for a month. You like it, you keep it, you make lots of money. You don't like it, we give you your money back. Check it out. Steve Rhodes, what's going on?
Well, I'm warming up. You know, I moved to Florida about 40 years ago to avoid the cold.
Yeah.
And this weekend, at least, you know, and I'm further south than you are, and it's hard to believe it's October 18th, or November 18th, I should say, and just simply how cold it got. So yeah,
we're definitely little babies. I heard you're on the air today. And folks, we really are. I mean, you should, yeah, so picture this. You know, what it was, Steve, was this. It was 65, folks, okay, yesterday during the day. But it was a raw 65, like when Steve was in Detroit or I was in Boston, that it felt like to us like 25, like our fingers are cold, you know, yeah.
No, absolutely. Absolutely.
It was disgusting, wasn't it? I know.
Yeah. Well, and we're really not really as prepared for it, you know. I don't really have much in the way of winter clothing any longer, some sweaters and stuff. But, you know, even worse for me, I was at the just normal doctor's appointment on Thursday. And, you know, he said, hey, based on your age and a couple other things going on, and because I had had shingles about 15, 20 years ago, he said, you've got to have this shingles vaccine.
That, you know. pneumonia shot. I heard. I know.
And and I got to tell you, the first 18 hours was okay.
Yeah.
But the following 48 hours was I've never gone through the sweats and chills so many times.
Really?
Yeah. Wow. So and then I finally did the lookup to see what the side effects were, and I was experiencing them. But then once they were done, which was about 3 o'clock in the afternoon yesterday, you know, everything came back to normal.
Feeling good. Okay.
Yeah. But in any event, so, you know, I always applaud you, as everyone should, just simply for the education opportunities that you bring to all of us. The reason that I'm here even chatting with you this afternoon is because that is how our relationship began. I also love emulating you and reading either, you know, different quotes from your cards and so forth. And so to begin our session today, Jim Rohn, who really was Tony Robbins' teacher.
Okay.
So one of his real primary. In fact, Tony worked for Jim. That's how he really began to learn about the self-help industry. And so Jim says a formal education will make you a living. Now, Jim has long since passed away, but okay. Self-education will make you a fortune. And I believe that that's what you do for each of us out here. You provide us with those self-education tools. And David and Basil and myself, Larry, we get the opportunity to pass along some of our self-education. That's what I'd like to do for the viewers and listeners out there today. And one of the tools that I want to share is just, it's simple. You don't have to be any kind of technician other than being able to identify for each calendar year where the high and low is.
Okay.
And that's what this first chart is showing. It's showing the prior year highs. So PYH is the signal. It's a weekly time frame chart for the Dow that we're looking at. And it shows what the prior year highs were from 2013 to 2018. And what we can see right now is that the Dow is trading above its prior year high out there, which is real important because if you can go back into the 2014-15 time period where the market was consolidating, what we can see here is that it was struggling to overcome the prior year highs. So it's important to understand, hey, where are we at right now with regard to the Dow? We can also see, if I just draw, Tom, a little rising trend line off of the first high in 2018 and then the second high in 2018, that it contained price earlier this year, but now the Dow has broken above that. And with it breaking above that, what we can also conclude, or what we can determine is that price may continue to move higher through the end of the year. And the reason is because of that favorable seasonal cycle. And so we cannot rule out a move higher into the end of the year out there. Now, typically, the seasonal cycle finds a bottom around the middle of October, around October 13th out there. In a slide or two, we'll come back and show you where that bottom occurred this year. This happens to be the quarterly Dow chart with all of its prior year high designations. That way, everybody that's watching our slides out here on Tiger TV, they can see that in down years, we typically don't see price trade above the prior year highs. You can come back into the 2000 top. You can take a look at the 2007-2008 top. And so just understanding where the year makes its high and whether price is able to trade above that level is a real helpful indicator as to whether price is actually breaking out or not. So we got two breakouts right now going on inside of the Dow. And I'm not saying that the Dow can't form some type of top this year. So let's go take a look at some of the current patterns that are underway and what to be watching for. So right now, the Dow has two A to B equals CD pattern formations that are underway. That was one of the first patterns that you taught me, Tom. And so there is one that's in black and one that is in red. It uses different swing points out here. And it shows that right now, the larger A to B equals CD, the Dow has priced itself up towards that one-to-one level, which is 28.057. The smaller A to B equals CD pattern has got a price projection of 28.245. The key here for this pattern to complete for me is we need to see some type of bearish reversal candle. So if there is a bearish reversal candle that forms over the coming days, that will signal the A to B equals CD pattern has completed. But if the pattern is going to complete and we're going to see some type of change in trend, we need to see price close below my oscillator and change line. I refer to it as my green line or green or red. And that price point right now is about 27 27,796. So if we see a bearish reversal candle, folks, watch for the 27,796 area. Another potential topping pattern is that we're in the TD setup 9 count. Today will be bar number 9. These blue arrows on this chart show other 9 counts that have identified tops and bottoms. So this is something to pay attention to. And it's also clear that on October 7th, when we were talking with each other, it was the low on October 3rd that formed that seasonal bottom. And that was because price was coming down and testing the TD 9 count breakout level out there. So there is the potential for a top, but we need to see some signals. And the reason why I'm looking at it is because the money, since the bottom that came in on that October 3rd timeframe, right now is equally being distributed between the U.S., Germany, Japan, emerging markets, and even light sweet food out there. So to sum it up, if we don't see some type of bearish reversal candle, prices are going to continue to edge their way higher. But there are topping signals.
And folks, now to get Steve's news out, just come over to our website at TFNN. We're the featured content to see maximum probability. Steve, have a great one, a safe one. Of course, look for a show tomorrow.
If you're not currently using the TAS profile scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome, folks. We have the Dow. Dow Industrials right now up 29. You get the NASDAQ up 8. S&Ps are up 2. Let's take a look at some of the higher volume equities out here. This will be, once again, a low volume market. Bottom line is that you have Chesapeake Energy. Oh, they're going out of business. They're down 52 cents, trading 64 cents. 5 cents, rather, trading 64 cents. You have GE down 10 cents. That's at 11.42. Bank of America is trading flat, 32.94. Yandex, interesting. That's up $4, trading $40. You get Facebook up $2. Disney's up $2.90. And NVIDIA. Let's go look at that NVIDIA. Now, NVIDIA's really caught a bid out here. That's up $8.33. They had come out with their numbers last week. Bottom line is that that takes some volatility last week. They went from 211 to 200. Today, it rejected 203 on the way down. Right now, you're trading at 212. That being said, what's happening with NVIDIA, when you take a look at this on a longer-term basis, this is slamming right into monster resistance. How this had come down in October and November of last year. We went from $292 and 2 months and went down to 133. So the resistance level, the top, well, not the top of the resistance, but right up $222. That's the number. That's the number to keep your eye on. Inside the NDX 100, the strength versus the weakness out here today, you get NVIDIA's that bringing the NASDAQ up. That's up 4%. AMD, another chip maker, up 3%. Netflix has caught a bid, up 2.7%. And Fox has caught a bid, also up 2%. Taken away from it, Mercado Libre is down 3%. You got Mylan Pharmaceutical off 2.6%. JD.com is down 2%. And you got Microchip Technology off 2%. If we actually go to the Russell itself, you're going to see, this divergence is pretty intense, folks. The bottom line is that the Russell itself, so picture this, okay? The Russell index is right now at 1592. The high of July of 2018 is 1740. Bottom line, and it's been testing, it's been trying to get out of this range now for 11 months. You know, 11 months, the top of this range is 1618. And right now you're at 1592. We've reached 1608 this month. Each and every time it basically gets up to those levels, it just gets slammed down the other side in a very fast way, too. So we'll see where that's going to shake out. We're going to take a look at the inside the Dow Industrials, the strength versus the weakness out here today, because, of course, you're at another all-time high. Point-wise, what we have is that you have United Health putting 24 positive points in, Disney putting 19, Home Depot putting 9. The only ones that basically get some negative coming into it is that oil market. Once again, you get Chevron putting 14 negative points, Boeing putting 14, Caterpillar putting 12, and 3M also putting 12. United Health, let's take a look at United Health. United Health is up $3.74. You're trading 273. The low for the year in United Health is 208. The high is 287. This equity has been on a tear, folks, in a huge way. You know, you bring this back 10 years, it's a 10-bagger. You know, 2010, you're at $28. All-time high in this baby is up there at 287, and right now you're at 273. And, you know, you get a high-end consolidation. It looks like it wants to get up and into those areas. So Amazon, just the opposite. You know, Amazon is up today. I think it was up $5.50 earlier when I looked. It's up $9 right now, $17.49. Now, Amazon is still having a very tough time holding price. And Amazon, you know, we're at all-time highs. Amazon's all-time high is $2,035, which is approximately $250 higher. Amazon hasn't been able to get out of this range. You know, I suspect Amazon actually wants to get out and test the 1672 area, which was the low of June. Google, different ballgame. We take a look at Google. Google is at highs, pressing highs. Last week, Google actually was pressing highs with volume. Once Google basically got out of this consolidation of 1273, bottom line is that this thing can go higher, and we'll see how much more it presses higher. But that is still a very strong stock. Microsoft, of course, that hit another all-time high today. That just continues hitting all-time highs, and Microsoft is still one of the strongest stocks inside the NDX 100 as well as the Nasdaq. In the newspaper business, okay, you know, we've seen this basically business go downtown for a long period of time, and you got McClatchy, okay, who publishes 29 newspapers, bottom line, they are going to be going south. If we pull this up, where do you see this? And you know what's so wild about this, folks, is that it always, you see this happen a lot inside public markets, that you have one sector that's going down. That sector, the equities in that sector, try to keep buying out the other folks in the sector, hoping that you get a turn in the sector or something happened. And bottom line, this company here had bailed out other companies in the last 15 years. I'm not quite sure. Yeah, well, they took them over. That's the real bottom line. Thought they didn't pay a lot, bottom line. Now what you have here is that you're going to see revenue-wise what you have out here. This is 28 newspapers. You can see in 2015 they were doing $1.1 billion. This year they're doing $711 million. They're contracting their advertising by 13% over a three-year period. That is a monster number. And all you have to do is look at this chart and see that bottom line is that the last 3 days, you just went from $2.49 to 57 cents. This is going to be the next one that's going to bite the dust. That's how this thing seems to be just shaking out. So sad but true, bottom line is that we'll see how they're going to basically structure those 28 papers. And that's a lot of papers, man. There's no two ways about that. Inside the gold market, the GDX. Let's go take a look at the GDX out here. GDX right now is trading up 38 cents. What this did last week is this, okay? We traded down to $25.97. You're trading at the strength. You rejected lower price. Bottom line, now what you're going to do, you're not only taking over the little swings from last week, you're going to have the volume behind this move out here today. So there's what we have is that you have a bit of divergence inside of the metal market versus the equities. The equities seem to be leading us here. If we go to the GLD and we take a look at the GLD, what you're going to see is that it has rejected lower price out here today. GLD is still going to need more volume. You know, the GLD... Right now, you're at 3.6 million shares. You're going into about 5.2. So I'd want to see more volume in there. That being said, the equities themselves are leading. There's no two ways about that. Silver, the metals market, the metal part of silver can. I'd like to see more volume in that part of it. But once again, if we go take a look at a few of these silver stocks, you're going to see that they are basically sitting right next to their September high. With Pan American Silver, September high, $19.48. The low of that high was 1862. We're trading 1872. So the silver equities also, not all of them, but there's plenty of them that are pushing those September highs and have volume behind the move. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in a Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now 14. You get the NASDAQ up 10. S&P is flat. ExxonMobil, let's take a look at a couple of these big oil companies. Exxon right now, folks, trading to $68. This has been a consolidation also at the lows of this consolidation at $66.52. Now, this is such a heads up in general, you know, that you get the Aramco IPO coming out, folks, that they thought they could basically paper over the aspect throughout the whole world, get something out of $2 trillion, and you have an ExxonMobil that's trading at the same price it was trading in 2006. So Exxon as well as Chevron have been showing that, you know, you can be the biggest oil company in the world, paying dividends on a continual basis, not saying it's going away, but there's something inside this oil market that is screaming that things are changing, and they have been changing for quite some time. When you have an ExxonMobil that's trading at a price point of 2006, that's telling you quite a bit. You know, we'll see whether it's going to, it looks to me like it's going to test the $56 area. 56 is the lows of 2008. That's how it seems to be shaken up. If it breaks that, then it's in big trouble. But I suspect it's going to basically get down there. That's your technical setup on it. The fundamental setup, when you look at this Aramco IPO, is pretty clear. You know, picture, you get the Saudis who have basically reserve oils, you know, some of the biggest in the world. That's what they're selling. They're selling to the public. First off, why are they selling to the public? My take would be they're selling to the public because they know what's coming down the peak, the line also. And what's coming down the line, which has been showing in the marketplace for quite some time, is that we have plenty of energy in a huge way. Between plenty of energy, plenty of gas, plenty of renewables, all of the above, it's pretty amazing. In fact, it was if you saw 60 Minutes last night, this was an amazing, I got to figure out the actual name of these. If you saw 60 Minutes last night, this was pretty cool. What this was about, it was about mining, okay, in the ocean. And in between Hawaii and Mexico, folks, there is this there's this ocean bed that is huge. And in that ocean bed, there's these, the ocean is actually growing them. Okay, it's been growing them over the course of, you know, hundreds of millions of years. The bottom line is that they're all laying on the ocean floor right now. And as you, they pick them up, and as they mine them, this is not gonna, there's not gonna be monster mining for about 3 years. But as they mine them, there's cobalt and lead in these, and there's enough to basically, this would be about the electrization of batteries. You know, if you Google it, it was a great story, man. And it looks to me like it's going to be commercially viable. And what that is going to do is that's going to bring down the battery business in an incredible way. So it's really intriguing that how these things show up, and all of a sudden a larger picture can change where, you know, we're not talking windmills, you're not talking basically conserving, you're talking basically something that's already out there. You get it, you put it inside the batteries, and it makes millions of batteries at a very inexpensive price. So we'll see where that baby goes. But to get back to the Aramco deal for a second, you know, you got to remember something, that the prince there had already put the wealthy Saudis in jail, extracted billions of dollars off them. What is happening with the IPO this time is that, number one, he has them all buying into the IPO. And then the kicker on top of that is that the central bank has changed the rules on leverage. And now that can happen, okay? Our own central bank, you know, years ago, I've seen them change years ago. So what they did is this. Let's say that you can only leverage 1-to-1, meaning that, you know, bottom line, if something's a dollar, you can leverage 50 cents. Well, in Saudi Arabia, they just double that leverage. So bottom line, they'll bring it up to about, they'll let you borrow about $75 on the $100. What that says, though, when you put that together, it says a couple of different things. It says, number one, that no one else across the world, they just pulled their IPO in the roadshow in London. They're not going to Canada. They're not going to the Asia, okay? This is a Saudi deal now. It's showing that the bigger players are not biting on something as large as the largest oil company in the world going public at that particular price. When I start looking at where ExxonMobil has been trading for a long time, we have a dynamic that's changing. And I suspect demand, even though there's more people on a continual basis, you know, you see, you just see more supply than demand. It's just like, that's all any price is about, folks. If there's more supply than demand, guess what? It makes the difference. And little by little, all these different alternate energies that are out there are chipping away at the oil market. That's what it seems like. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. When we start talking energy, go out to California, we start talking about PG&E. Bottom line is that, you know, they have already filed for bankruptcy. Bottom line, we'll see whether they can end up getting out of bankruptcy. Why? Because from when they had filed to where they are at this particular point, this is a stock. Let me see what it's trading at. I think it's trading at $7 right now still, which just is crazy. Let me see. PG. Yeah, he's still trading at $7. They, of course, had more problems with the rest of the fires that they had in the last month. Yeah, so this is the equity went from $71 down to $7. And now what's going on is that what happens, folks, is that the type of bankruptcy that they're in, they're trying to basically have the bankruptcy done, get bridge money so that they can be up and going again. And as of this morning, what ended up happening is that their commitment has been cut in half from the last month. Okay, the first they had said they had $14 billion in commitments. Bottom line, right now, they're only at $7.4 billion. They have to reach $12 billion by December 6th in order to basically have a chance of basically not a total liquidation. My take on that is that what they have to get done, and that's going to be the state of California, somehow there has to be a guard against a liability that these fires are basically going to bring down the company again. Because the bottom line is that, folks, California, where we're talking, you know, yes, they got plenty of trees right now, but California's still a desert. You know, Colorado River coming in, yeah. Bottom line, other than that, you got a desert. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Basil Chapman has just announced a live 90-minute webinar he'll be conducting for subscribers to his daily trading newsletter, The Opening Call, which will be taking place Tuesday, November 19th from 5 till 6:30 p.m. Eastern Time, titled A Comprehensive Review of the Chapman Wave Techniques and Market Outlook Ahead for 2020. This is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial to The Opening Call while gaining access to Basil's live subscriber event taking place later this month. With some stock picks up 15 to 30% this year alone, Basil will review many of the Chapman Wave techniques that helped in their successful analysis, as well as providing the sectors and stocks that he thinks will be of importance heading into 2020. For all the details, check out the opening call on the front page of TFNN.com.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionics, oil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated fulvic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's up 19, Nasdaq's up 2, S&P's are up 1. Looks like we're still going to be at an all-time high. And folks, as you come over to our website at TFNN, you're going to see right under featured content. Our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, is going to be doing a webinar tomorrow night for his subscribers. Very easy to be a subscriber of his, folks. This webinar is going to go on for an hour and a half. The way you do it, you come over to our website at TFNN. You'll see the opening call. You just hit subscribe. You can get his opening call for 1 month, 6 months, a year. Now, they all come with a 30-day money-back guarantee. So what ends up happening, it doesn't matter which one you get. If you like the newsletter, right, you can keep the newsletter. If you don't like the newsletter in 30 days, we give you your money back. First off, you're going to come into a great webinar tomorrow night from 5 to 6:30. If you can't make it live, this is archived. It'll be on your site for a full 30 days. And then once you do subscribe, there's 5 other webinars inside that are on your page immediately. So check it out right on the front page of TFNN. We take a look at the marketplace out here, folks. What you're going to have, you got another all-time high. inside the NYSE. We're doing 511, so it'll be doing about 800 million inside the NYSE out here today. Inside the NASDAQ composite, we're at 1.7, so that's going to do, let's say, a couple billion shares out here. We take a look at the SPY, which is at an all-time high. You get another contraction. We have contractions almost every day inside the SPY. Friday had a little pop. Bottom line, still the contractions are out there. Inside the NDX 100, same setup. Bottom line, you are at another all-time high. It's been a one-way move. There's no doubt about that. We take a look at this market. You go right back to October 3rd. Inside the Qs, we're at 181. Now you're at 203. Hit 203.39 out here. And as I said a little bit earlier, small caps, bottom line, can't catch a bid. No doubt about that. Dollar index, looks like the rest of the week we're going to be pushing low in the dollar index. Gold, silver, they rejected lower price once again. They want higher price. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step inside of it, take ownership, and fly with it. Everything you need is right inside you. We look forward to seeing you right back here tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock, with our man, Mr. Larry Pesavento. Go get him, folks.